tacos. The line was long and they ran out of cherry cola. C-O-L-A cola. I went outside and I met a man. He seized on me. Now I'm coming down with Ebola. E-B-O-L-A Ebola. Oh no no Ebola.
Popping me right here, they say Ebola every time. You scary, yo man. You know what I mean?
Something happened.
Something hit up. Oh yeah, the news. I said something hit up. Yeah.
Oh.
Mr. President, in your recent budget, just to make sure I understand, you're asking for a $50 billion emergency defense supplemental to protect America from zombies.
I believe this is the great challenge of the beginning of the 21st century.
Zombies, who eat brains, just so I know we're on the same page here.
That's what they do. That's what they've said they want to do. They have objectives.
With all due respect, Mr. President, are you sure this wasn't a movie you saw? I mean, why?
Because they're real.
Yeah, but why is
that? And it's a danger to the American people. It's a danger to your children, Jim.
Sorry, my name is Barry.
Chen.
No, Barry.
Ed.
It's Barry. Just think of blueberry or strawberry. That way you'll always remember it.
Thanks, Ed. They are a direct threat to the United States, and I'm going to keep talking about it.
The zombies. You say they're eating our brains.
They need to be eating U.S. beef. It's good for them.
Okay.
They'll like it.
For the sake of argument, even in the movies, zombies seem to move really, really slowly. Why couldn't we just outrun them?
If we leave, they follow us.
Right.
Secret history looks at killer flu.
People didn't want to believe that they could be healthy in the morning and dead by nightfall. They didn't want to believe that.
It was the worst epidemic the world has ever known. It attacked over 1 billion people, more than half the Earth's population.
It was a phantom, and we didn't know where it was.
A senior law enforcement source told CBS 4 News that a preliminary toxicology report shows Eugene had marijuana in his system.
Dr. Rebecca Carley is a medical doctor, a surgeon by trade. Her son got vaccine damage. She began to investigate it, and I think some of her research is some of the best I've seen.
You say they're eating our brains.
They need to be eating U.S. beef. It's good for them.
Okay.
They'll like it.
For the sake of argument, even in the movies, zombies seem to move really, really slowly. Why couldn't we just outrun them?
If we leave, they follow us.
Right.
Just go! Jesus fucking Christ!
Oh my God. Scott! What the fuck, man?
Dan! Call an ambulance!
Rebecca Carley is a medical doctor, a surgeon by...
I told
totally agree with you that he was most likely on Prozac or some other psychotropic med.
Well, it's coming out the German. It's coming out the German was under psychiatric care, so he's guaranteed on it, but go ahead.
Right. I just want to bring out the fact that vaccinations can also cause violent behavior. There's an excellent book entitled Vaccination, Social Violence, and Criminality by Harris Coulter, which the listeners can obtain from thinktwice.com. And there's certain areas of the brain that, in fact, lead you to become violent. I have in front of me a book published by NATO, North Atlantic Treaty Organization, called The Biology of Aggression, which is, it's over 600 pages long. They're actually researching to see what areas of the brain they can affect to make people violent, and they're using rabies virus to do so.
Yes, now, Doctor, I've read the medical major...
Hey! Get away from her! Stop! Stop hitting her! What are you doing? I'll show you!
Wait, how many times did you shoot him?
Like three or four times?
He's naked, you shot him, and he doesn't care, he's eating another girl's face? This is zombie, you idiot!
What?
This is awesome! Wait, haven't you always wanted a zombie apocalypse?
No!
I have, like, since I was a child. Make life more interesting, okay? Let him go!
Backside of the closed Walmart in Durham, North Carolina. Taking a look here, what I can see. Bear with me, folks.
Hey, this is, believe it or not, inside of Camp St. Teresa. This is the first makeshift clinic that they had set up, and you're not going to believe the size of this thing.
You know, when you first heard it, you're like, come on, that's kind of conspiracy, because, I mean, who names something Agenda 21? I mean, when I flew into Seattle Airport one night, and the Department of Homeland Security actually paints their helicopters, I'm not kidding, black. And I'm like, come on, guys. Really, you've got actual black helicopters.
They said they want to do. They have objectives.
With all due respect, Mr. President, are you sure this wasn't a movie you saw? I mean, why?
These are real.
Yeah, but why is
that? It's a danger to the American people. It's a danger to your children, Jim.
Sorry, my name is Barry.
Chen.
No, Barry.
Ed.
It's Barry. Just think of blueberry or strawberry. That way you'll always remember it.
Thanks, Ed. They are a direct threat to the United States. And I'm going to keep talking about it.
The zombies. You say they're eating our brains.
They need to be eating U.S. beef. It's good for them.
Okay.
They'll like it.
Attack at a Dallas intersection when a naked man jumped into a woman's car. Good evening. I'm John McKay.
And I'm Cynthia Seguire. A witness grabbed his cell phone and caught that attack on video. He captured the attack from his apartment last Friday in Oak Cliff on Zane Boulevard, just east of I-35. You can see the naked man try to climb through the sunroof.
Okay, there's a guy that just got naked in the middle of the street.
The man shooting this video from his Oak Cliff apartment Friday thought he was capturing the craziest thing he'd ever seen until that man came back into frame.
Oh, he just jumped in these people's car.
Nude with no fear at the corner of Zang and Oakenwald, he slid arms first into the open sunroof of this woman's car.
A naked man jumped in. He jumped in my car and he started attacking me. He started choking me, pulling my hair, pulling my eye.
Oh my gosh.
As he clawed at her, the car slid. The police were there and tried to call him off of her until they crashed.
Oh my gosh.
I feel more afraid, like a prisoner.
Well, new at 5, the Secret Service arrested a man who was naked outside the White House. A spokesperson with the service says Michael Bouchard approached officers outside the White House and took off all his clothes. As they tried to arrest him, Bouchard assaulted two of the officers. He was arrested on 2 counts of assault and 1 count of indecent exposure. He was taken to the hospital to be treated for minor injuries he received when he attacked the officers.
Congress shall now vote for approval of H.R. 8791, the Homeland Terrorism Preparedness Bill. Said bill requests emergency response funding up to and including this section is classified. Dollars to prepare for a national level terrorist attack and or attack from classified. Funding for first responder personnel and vehicles would be doubled if said attack leads to more than 80% of national population being affected by classified. This funding shall commence in conjunction with the first attack on classified or the first large scale outbreak of classified, dependent upon which comes first. Civilian and military units shall be trained in containment and combat of classified, including irradiated classified, with possibility of classified airborne, classified flesh-eating, classified, and or all of the above, in such event as classified spewing, classified escape, are released or otherwise become uncontrollable. Air Force units may also be directed to combat said classified due to their enormous size and otherworldly strengths. Should event occur in urban areas, Jesus, that's classified, far surpassing our darkest nightmares. Should casualties exceed, classified body disposal actions shall be halted and associated resources shall be reallocated to classified underground, classified protected birthing centers. A new Bill of Rights shall be drafted and approved by classified. Having now reviewed the bill, I ask you to please cast your vote.
Oh my God, what do you do? Oh my God, what do you do?
Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God,
what the f***? Oh my God.
Oh my God.
And
what are you doing?
Frightening video just obtained by CBS2 of an attack at an Orange County intersection. A naked man tried to jump into a vehicle. Watch the video. You can then see him attack a woman and try to drag her away. Other witnesses intervened to get the man away from that woman and then detained the man until police arrived. Now, we're told this happened yesterday in Garden Grove near Magnolia and Westminster, but the tape is just coming to light now. That suspect was detained by Garden Grove Police.
To the police department and to my Heavenly Father for being there for me today.
Ramona Villarreal is very seriously thanking God she gets to drive home tonight. She watched as a man squared off with police right in front of her office building. First tased 3 times. Then police say an officer fired 1 shot to his chest.
Had him apprehended on the ground and he was still fighting him even after he had been shot.
Shocking, but nothing compared to what she'd seen seconds before. That man terrorizing the medical testing center where she works.
Beating his his chest and being crazy outside of our window, where he disrobed, took all his clothes off, and threw him down the stairwell.
It felt like they were being held hostage until he finally went outside, where police were waiting.
So it was a very surreal, hard day today.
Last week, a 37-year-old Joppa man was reported missing from his home. Investigators started a missing persons search, and yesterday ended up executing a search and seizure warrant on a home in the 500 block of Terrapin Terrace. Inside, they found the remains of the victim, who's identified as Cujo Agye Cody. They have arrested a 21-year-old Morgan State University student named Alexander Kinyao. According to charging documents, Kinyao admitted that he had eaten portions of the victim's brain and heart, and investigators found his head and his hands in metal tins in the home. Kinyao has a bail review hearing today in Harford County District Court, and police have scheduled a press conference for 3 p.m.
Discovery in a Harford County neighborhood. Body parts strewn across two different blocks. Tonight, detectives say they could be linked to a missing man. WJZ was first on the scene. Megan McCorkle is live with new details just in from investigators. Megan.
Denise.
At a Dallas intersection when a naked man jumped onto a woman's car. Good evening. I'm John McKay.
Hey! Get away from her!
Wait, how many times did you shoot him?
Like three or four times?
He's naked, you shot him, and he doesn't care, he's eating another girl's face? This is zombie, you idiot!
Forces are preparing a last-ditch effort in order to stop the infestation at its source.